So let's get it. It's another morning. I still don't got my running legs yet. My mind's still not clear, but I gotta get this workout in. So this morning I jumped on my Peloton to do a little cycling. When you work this type of career, you gotta try to get it in where you can fit it, because you never know when you're gonna get off when you're out here ripping and running these streets and saving lives. Sometimes I feel like they brought us back to the office and brought all these employees back to the office just so we can spend money at the gas station. And with the inflation, it's sure hurting a lot of people's pockets. They got us back in these offices spending money at the gas station, at the vending machines, at the Dunkin' Donuts, out here buying lunch, trying to boost the U.S. economy again. But me, I got about 14 weeks and 3 days to go until it's time to retire. I got my son tonight, picked him up when I got off of work. And I came out here to my man cave to get a little workout in and just chill out and relax and listen to the rainfall. There's something about the rain that helps me relax, calm me down. I'm still excited that I'm no longer selling this house. I remember when I first found this neighborhood, going on one of my morning runs. And I went running. I found this community, nice, peaceful, quiet community. And then me and my wife found this property.
I'm serious.
And like Franklin said, from Snowfall, it was somewhere where I thought I was going to just build my legacy, build our family legacy,
build a basketball court on top of the hill
where we could call home, raise our kids. And so, with all the space, I had so many ideas. What to do with all this land? Building over water cabanas. With the trees that I chopped down. I didn't want to cut the trees down, but they was kind of leaning over the man cave. So I had to get the trees down so they wouldn't fall over and knock it down. And with the logs, I built this nice over the water cabana. And the house was set on the lake when we had a boat. Take the kids and go out fishing. And we had this old tool shed. And when I first found this property, I always had this idea that this tool shed could turn into an indoor basketball court. And so what I did, I got my tools and I turned the shed into an indoor basketball court because it had such the high ceiling. And we got my brother-in-law to help build the treehouse. I always wanted a treehouse for myself. So we made sure we built the treehouse strong enough for me and the kids. It's mainly for the kids, but I wanted a balcony put on the treehouse so I could sit out there and just chill out and relax. When you deal with the type of career that I have, you need somewhere to come home and relax to. And now that I no longer had the tool shed because I turned it into a basketball court, I decided to go ahead and build a new tool shed, just as big. So all by myself, during the pandemic, I would rip and run to Home Depot and buy all the material that I need to go ahead and build this shed. I should have rented a concrete mixer, but I was taught by my father when I was younger how to mix concrete myself. So I would just use the bags, get the water, and go ahead and mix it all myself.
Backbreaking work, but it's worth it.
And I'll bring my son out to help me. Of course, Milan will always want to come too. So I don't discriminate. I let my daughter come out and watch us too. And so we built a tool shed just as big. And right after the tool shed, we built a dog park somewhere to put Nola, our dog. All throughout the pandemic, we was back and forth to Home Depot. I wanted to protect the kids from deer ticks, so I wound up fencing my whole yard in so no deer could come back there. And so my kids can peacefully lay out in the grass. Even though the community had an outdoor pool for the whole community, it was closed during the pandemic. So my wife decided that we should put a pool in the backyard, which we did. And then my brother-in-law helped build the pool deck around the pool. And my wife got her hot tub that she always wanted. Something that we are packing up and bringing with us to Mexico.
And weirdos of the pure soul that would go to the flea market.
Behind the M and the F. I made sure I put our names on the fence. Cause like I said, like Franklin said, I wanted a home for our family, somewhere to build a legacy. Somewhere to share experiences. And as we move to Mexico, we're gonna always keep this home in our name. There was just so much room for activities. A place to always come back to. But we look forward to moving forward.